Assalamu alaikum. 4 months ago, during my time on the student administration office, I had a conversation with the administration coordinator. During our discussion, she shared with me her concerns about her six-month-old baby boy named Adam. She mentioned that he started to demonstrate a control of his head in upright position, but she observed that he frequently tilts his head toward the right side. Additionally, she noticed that the right side of his neck is larger than the left side, leading her to suspect an enlarged lymph node. Following a routine checkup with a pediatrician, she was informed that her baby may have some kind of congenital anomaly that requires immediate initiation of physiotherapy. Seeking advice, she approached Dr. Naguib, the dean of our faculty, who recommended her to consult with me due to my specialization in pediatric rehabilitation. Overwhelmed with worry, she tearfully asked me a series of questions. How did this issue arise? What are the underlying causes? In attempt to assure her, I explained that this problem is common and often manageable through physical therapy. However, I emphasized on examining the baby firsthand and assess his specific case. I invite you to place yourself in this scenario as it serves as the purpose of this lesson. I promise you, by the end of this lesson, you will acquire new knowledge and be able to identify congenital muscular torticollis, understand the causes and mechanism behind CMT, learn how to assess and evaluate the severity of CMT causes. Torticollis or re-neck is twisting of the neck to one side. It occurs as a result of shortening of or unilateral shortening of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, resulting in tilting of the neck to the affected side, rotation to the opposite side, and you may notice that the sternocleidomastoid muscle is cord-like, is tensed and cord-like. It may come with facial asymmetry or even head asymmetry, what's called plagiocephaly. And as a result of this shortening, there is limitation of the range of motion of the head and neck. CMT is usually noticed in the first 2 to 3 weeks of birth, and its incidence is from 0.4% up to 1.9%. A mass of fibrotic tumor may be observed and bulbable in the belly of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and it is thought that all congenital muscular torticollis have this enlargement. Okay, let's talk about the etiology or the cause. The exact cause of the congenital muscular torticollis is unknown, but there are some explanations. Researchers have hypothesized that occlusion of blood vessels with the resultant of anoxic injury or lack of oxygen injury to the sternocleidomastoid muscle may produce fibrotic changes observed within the muscle. This is one of the explanations of what's called the mass or sternocleidomastoid tumor. Another supposed cause is intrauterine malpositioning. Infants with CMT have higher incidence of breech presentation and associated congenital musculoskeletal anomalies such as hip dysplasia and foot deformities. Birth trauma. Injury to the muscle usually occurs during birth. Overstretching of the sternocleidomastoid muscle during delivery of the head may cause tear of some of the muscle fibers, resulting in fibrotic changes, scar tissue formations, and the formation of this mass. As we said, several surgeons suppose that all congenital muscular torticollis come with fibrotic tumors, and the size of this tumor specify its severity. So congenital muscular torticollis often classified into three clinical groups. The first classification is a sternocleidomastoid tumor, SMT, when a definitive mass or tumor is palpable within the sternocleidomastoid muscle. The second classification is muscular torticollis, MT, when contractures of the sternocleidomastoid muscle is present, but there is no palpable mass is present. The last classification is where there is no mass, and when you apply the flexibility test for the sternocleidomastoid muscle, you won't find shortening. But the child take a behavior of tilting his head to one side. This is a positional behavior. So this classification is called positional torticollis. Adam come to start physical therapy, and before putting the physical therapy plan, I have to evaluate the infant. The evaluation of such case is as the evaluation of any pediatric case. So you apply the full evaluation method, the pediatric physical therapy evaluation method, starting from observation, history taking about present history, past history, maternal history, and obstetric history, prenatal, perinatal, and postnatal history, and apply full musculoskeletal and neurological examination. Also, you examine the developmental status of the child. As CMT may comes with another problems, associated problems like other congenital anomalies, such as hip dysplasia or foot deformities. Most of the CMT cases have moderate developmental delay. So the aim of the evaluation is to list the case problems to both a solutions for each problem in a form of treatment program. Let's now start the specific evaluation for CMT case. Start with observation. Observe the child's head in relation to the rest of his body, the way of his looking. You may find the child preferred looking to one side rather than the other. Also, observe the distance between his ear loop and the shoulder, and you will find differences between both sides. Definitely, the affected side has a short distance. Also, observe skin caries. You will find the affected side have more skin folds than the other side. Also, check facial asymmetry. Normally, the child's cheeks are the same shape, and in case of CMT, you will find facial asymmetry. Usually the affected side is flattened than the sound side. Also, you observe his shoulder may be elevated at the affected side. You may found head asymmetry. This asymmetry is due to he usually, when he lie on his back, turn his head to one side, and the pressure may happens on one side rather than the other. This deformation of the head is called plagiocephaly. After observation, apply the palpation. With the child lying on his back, start to palpate the sternocleidomastoid muscle, starting from the mastoid process at the skull all down to the sternum. Your palpation should be done manually to observe the difference and to palpate whether he has a fibrotic mass or not. After observation and palpation, let's continue our musculoskeletal examination, as this problem is specifically a musculoskeletal problem. Start with examining the range of motion, the active and passive range of motion, and evaluating the muscle power. On screening his range of motion of a child, you can use your weapon, a toy, okay? And let the child track the object, both him on your lap or in any position, and start to observe his range of motion using visual tracking. So the attractive object, like a toy, and grab her attention and move the toy to one side, so he rotate his head to this side to observe the active rotational range of motion, and move the object to the other side to observe the rotation and compare between both sides. Usually, he has a limitation in rotating his head towards the affected side, which in case of Adam, the right side. You can use the writing reaction to evaluate the side bending or tilting of his head, especially if the infant age is above 6 months. You can examine it on your lab or using a medical ball. Grasp the child under his axilla like this, and then tilt his trunk to one side about 45 degrees and wait for the response. The child usually will right his head, tilt his head to the opposite side. This is will clarify the range of motion of the side bending to the right side. Then tilt the infant to the other side, and he will tilt his head like so, and you will evaluate the active range of motion. Also, these techniques can be used to evaluate the muscle activity of his neck. You may find some weakness of one side rather than the other. Usually, the sound side is weaker. Also, you can apply passive range of motion. Just hold the head from his sides. Do not press over his fontanelles. So we just hold his head like this and avoid pressing his ears to not be irritated, and apply side bending like this or side bending like this and rotation from side to side. You can apply it from erect position or from supine position. All of this is just screening. It is informal evaluation. You can shift to the formal evaluation by getting some numbers. To evaluate the range of motion, you have to use geniometric tools. We can use the inclinometer to assess the side bending of the head. Also, we can use the orthodial protractor to assess the side bending and also to assess the head rotation. To evaluate muscle power, you can use writing reaction. And there is a scale called muscle function scale, is based on this concept. By holding the child in a horizontal position, especially if he had more than 6 months, and infant develop postural reactions, normally he can tilt his head up to a right angle or 75 degrees. According to the ability to right his head, he can right his head according to his muscle power, the level of his muscle power. The muscle function scale is a 6 grades scale. The first grade, when holding the child in horizontal position, his head will be lower than the horizontal position. And in this case, we give him grade 0. If his head position is with the horizontal line, we give him grade 1. If his head above the horizontal line, about 15 degrees, below 45 degrees, we give him grade 2. If his head position is about 45 degrees from the horizontal line, we give him grade 3. If the head position is above 45 degrees, we give him grade 4. If his head position is about to right angle up to 75 degrees, we give him grade 5. Now you have learned what is the congenital muscular torticollis, how it is happening and its causes, and the specific evaluation, physical therapy evaluation for such case. To read more about congenital muscular torticollis, I recommend some textbooks. Ticklin's Pediatric Physical Therapy, 5th edition, part 3, Musculoskeletal Disorder, chapter 13. Also, I recommend Meeting Physical Therapy Needs of Children, 2nd edition, Musculoskeletal System, Consideration and Intervention for Specific Pediatric Cases.